now deceased, about Langston Hughes visiting Cuba. And he says, my brother, when he sends the letter to Nicolakian, he says, my brother, when Langston gets to Cuba, I want him to see the African population of Cuba. At that time, connecting the African-American experience or the Afro-Cuban experience or the Afro-Puerto Rican experience was absolutely visionary and pioneering. It is now that people are beginning to understand that we are connected. You don't learn that in school. Even Black studies and race studies puts things into compartments. You're either African-American or you're Jamaican or whatever, but does not understand the connectivity of our experience. So that what he was developing was a new scholarship, which we're now beginning to embrace with people understanding that there are more African descendants in Brazil, right, than there are, than they were brought to the United States, for example. You had a population of 6 million that were taken to Brazil. 500,000 to the United States. Puerto Rico, about 200,000, depending on the statistics that you want to take. Cuba, about 1,000, you know, Haiti, Trinidad. So when you understand that the connectivity that he was already forging was not understood because there was not the courses or the framework for that, you understand the power of the mind of Schomburg. And it's now that it's beginning to be implemented in part in Africana studies and Latino studies not yet. Now remember that it's only in 2001 that the United Nations in South Africa, and I was part of that conference, begins to address global racism. And I think that I don't want to say how many of us descended on South Africa, but we were very clear that the terminology that would unite us was African descendants. Yes, you could be Afro-Boricua, and I'm in accord with, you know, the speakers as well, but we understood that power meant understanding that we were part of a global reality that distributed more than 50 million Africans throughout the world. And if we were going to have power as a people, we have to be defined as African descendants. And that's what Schomburg understood. So that, yes, you identify globally with your group, right? Be it Afro-Puerto Rican, be it Afro-Dominican, be it, you know, Afro-Panamanian. But then in the global political sense, you have to connect.